Sasha!
That you come unarmed.
Yeah, well, unarmed I ain't never gonna do, am I? And as for the crane, don't worry about that. Just me sciatica, huh? Always plays up around the winter and the summer solstice.
What have you got for me, Alfie?
What'd you bring me out here for, huh?
Get some more liquid, aim, so in the boy. Yeah, I have very bad things about you Birmingham people. You're gypsies, right? So what? You live in a fucking tadpole caravan?
I came here to talk business with you, Mr. Solomons.
Well, rum is for finding fucking, isn't it? Now whiskey. Now that's for business.
Let's talk first, eh?
Suit yourself.
What have you got for me, Alfie?
Well, seeing you was prepared to pay such an exuberant amount for this information, I decided to give you value for money. So, here are the names, right, of all the men in England, right, who will buy an old Fabergé egg. There you go. And then, here's all the men, right, on that list, who will buy an old Fabergé egg, even if they knew that that item was stolen. There you go. And then, here comes your curious fucking gibbo question. All nice, but here's all the men on that list, right, who will buy the old Fabergé egg because of their wise obsession. Oh, yes! Thank you, Mr. Shelby. Lovely doing business with you.
Left the name off the list, Alfie.
Did I?
You left the richest name off the list, Alfie.
Yeah, well, if you knew, how come you brought me all the way out here in the fucking argument for, mate, huh?
Suit yourself. They say you had your life saved by police.
Policeman on Loch Farrell.
Well, I don't like policemen, because policemen, they can't be trusted.
Mr. Sabina? He uses policemen all the time. That's why he's winning the war in London. You are losing it.
War ain't over till it's over, mate. You in the war. You know, I once carried out my own personal fool with Steve Mortar, on an Italian. I pushed his face up against the trench. He shoved a 6-inch nail up his fucking nose and I hammered it home with a fucking dartboard. It was fucking biblical, mate. So now you come in here and sit there in my chair and tell me that I'm losing my war to a fucking whoop.
That war was a long time ago. You need to be more realistic.
Realistic, eh? Realistic?
If you weren't losing the war, you wouldn't have sent me the telegram.
Really? You forgot your fucking telegram. Your telegram just said, hello. Very simple. You want to sell me something. What?
Reasons. Reason one, by withholding a name you most certainly knew, proving to me you did a deal with the young fellow. Reason two, name of the man you're withholding must be my enemy. Otherwise, you wouldn't be protecting him.
Tommy, sweetheart, you can't take him.
Yeah, I gave information in exchange for a share.
Tommy! There were things in that treasury, right? God himself, he spoke to me. He said, Alfie, you were meant to have these things.
You crossed the line, Alfie.
The line? What fucking line?
The line that isn't my fucking boy, Alfie! Did you fucking know?
Yeah, I knew, you know, damn, the fires have made no fucking difference to me, mate. The fuck is wrong with you, Tommy, huh? You got fucking angry, ain't you?
You're fucking angry, you're fucking angry, Alfie. I'll blow your fucking head off right now. I would end the trust with the fucking London out from here. I'll fucking kill you, man.
Yeah, well, Tommy, you know, you're not gonna worry about that old fucking old truce, right? Because it all just went to hell, right? You got nothing to worry about, right, when it comes to the old scary London boys.
I know what I'm saying makes you angry, but I'm offering you a solution. See, Mr. Sabini has run all your bookies off all your courses. He's closed down the premises that take your room. People don't trust your protection anymore.
You're the bloke that shot Billy Kimball, right? That's you. You did, right? You fucking shot him, mate. You fucking betrayed him, mate. So it'll be entirely appropriate to do what I'm thinking in my head to you right now.
Can offer you 100 good men, all with weapons, and a new relationship with the police.
Intelligence is a very valuable thing, isn't it, my friend? And usually it comes far too fucking late. Let's say I shot you already, right? In the fucking face. And the bullet goes bone, mush, bone cabinet over there. Which is a shame, isn't it? Because that cabinet's fucked now and I'm gonna get short of it. So, what I do is this. It's fucking simple, mate. Cut the cabinet literally in half, right? I cut the cabinet. I do. I cut the cabinet literally in half, right? And I take one half of the cabinet, right? And I put it into a barrel. And I take the other cabinet, right? In all its pieces, and I put it into another barrel, right? And I take this barrel and I send it off to Mandalay. In the other barrel, I send it off to somewhere like, I don't know, Timbuktu. You ever been?
No.
No? Would you like to go?
No.
You know, I always thought you have a great big fucking gold ring in your nose.
I'm sorry. Go on. That's your plan.
What fucking side are you on, Alfie?
I don't give a fuck right now, kid, right? I do not want you, right, to spare me because of some fucking beast bat. I want you to acknowledge that your anger is unfucking justified. I want you to acknowledge that he who fights by the sword, he fucking dies, boy, you Tommy. So what? He took your boy, huh? He got your boy. And what fucking line am I supposed to have crossed, huh? How many fathers, right? How many sons, yeah? Have you cut, killed, murdered, fucking butchered, innocent and guilty, to send them straight to fucking hell, ain't you? Just like me. You stand there, you, judging me, stand there and talk to me about crossing some fucking line. If you pull that trigger, right? You pull that trigger for an honorable fucking reason, mate. Like an honorable man. Not like some fucking civilian that does not understand the wicked ways of our world, mate.
Well said, Alfie. Well said.
I did not know about your boy, though.
I know. I saw.